All right, now let's talk about capillary bleeding in the workplace. What you've got here is a classic road rash type of wound, or a rug burn, or when they fall and they hit the floor. This happened to be on a sander, but the injury is exactly the same. It's characteristically going to have this kind of this blood droplet that comes out of the capillaries and is mixed with a serous fluid. What is that? Serous fluid is the same fluid that fills a blister of a burn, or if you've ever gotten a rug burn, it oozes that. It's not blood, it's more like a yellowish kind of a liquid. That's the body's attempt to heal the wound, and it mixes now with the capillary bleeding. And so you can have this kind of bleeding issue, but it's stopped quite easily. The thing here is that we need to keep it clean. If they fell on dirty surfaces, we might have sand, dirt, rocks, metal shavings, wood shavings to clean out. If this is embedded, that's a med center call. Now they need to get in there and actually maybe numb it, because it's very painful. It's not deep enough to actually damage most of the nerve endings, and so road rash actually hurts worse than most other bleeding types. And it's because it's just a braze through that epidural layer, and the nerve endings are raw, and they're just overstimulated. So we need to be aware of that while we're treating that kind of road rash, that kind of capillary wound. But the major thing to do is wash it with soap and water, get most of the debris out. Then we're going to cover it with a bandage. Again, direct pressure for a little bit. It's not gonna hurt that bad. Again, it's not actively bleeding. So once we actually dab it off and control most of the bleeding, we're able to now use an over-the-counter triple antibiotic, apply the triple antibiotic to the wound after it's clean. This is gonna help us defeat any secondary infection that this part of the raw wound may have been exposed to. We're then going to get another 4x4 bandage with some tape. We're gonna cover the wound. Can you hold that for me, sir? And then we're gonna take some medical grade tape, and we're going to run a couple strips over the bandage to hold it in place. And as this begins to heal and the bleeding is controlled, give it maybe a day or so, this is going to be probably a large Band-Aid. A large Band-Aid could cover this and they could return back to normal activities. We encourage the patient to look for signs of infection. Oozing, it's hurting, it's turning red around it and becoming puffy and sore and actually maybe draining some pus. That needs to be seen at the med center or the ER. We don't want this to get so bad that they develop a serious infection that could actually get absorbed into the blood, cause a bloodstream infection, which we call septicemia. We also don't want to take for granted that it could just be a nuisance infection that could have been prevented because we didn't wash it well and we didn't put triple antibiotic on it. After we do this, give it 48 to 72 hours, it will begin to crust over, which is the scabbing, and that's natural. The person should return normal in another couple weeks, when the scabs fall off, and now it's back to healing scar tissue. Again, capillary bleeding is not necessarily a life-threatening emergency, but the infections that could follow from not taking care of it while it's healing is where we run into trouble.